baddest players out there. People used to mock him when he said, I want to make it to TI. Now it'd be crazy to think he won't make it to TI. We're going into game number four now. What could be the last match for the Nun Young Championships? Let's send it to our casters now. It's Eldie and Guns. Gentlemen, take it away.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We're live here from the SunTech Convention Center. It's time for what could be, Guns, the final game of the Nun Young Grand Finals. If VG Gaming can't find solutions to the WIPO.
And what better way to either end things or go to a game five? This is spicy, that little guy would say. And, well, VG Gaming have their work cut out for them to deal with the Weeha Meepo.
Gods, you actually play a lot of Meepo. Well, not so much lately. Thoughts on this game? Is this a good Meepo game? An okay Meepo game? A bad Meepo game? Where do you rank it?
It's pretty damn good. There is not a single, like, stun on the Radiant side. Meepo hates versing AoE stuns, hates versing burst damage. Good burst damage coming out from the Timbersaw and single target focus fire from a Klinx, but without the lockdown, I think VG Gaming will really struggle this game. It's not even just about controlling the Meepo, it's also heroes like the SF, the Darkseer. These heroes are just going to have free reign over team fights. It's going to be so easy to escape ganks as well. These scrolls are going to be Secret's best friend, considering the lack of disable on the side of VG Gaming.
All right, the horn blows, and we are underway now. Game four. Let the Meepo show commence.
Well, LD, we've seen it all. Shadow Fiend has a Mango. That's going to be a first.
All right. Well, not often we see the old Shadow friend sneaking off to the side lane. Normally, he's a manly man, he'll go mid, but not the case here. And a hide. So it will be a Lich Meepo dual lane mid up against the Big Bad Viper. Of course, annoying for the Meepo early on here, Gods, but with those denies, Weeha should be just fine. So FY, he's going to be the wild card. He looks to change things up. We've seen his Jungle Doom take off, take over games early. He does get an early Alpha Wolf.
And he's looking to be aggressive. The fact he's in the dire jungle is because it gives him access to gank both the secret safe lane and the mid lane.
Oh man, that crit. Whew, off the bat.
Yep.
Gonna make Puppy sweat a little bit.
This is not a greedy jungle play from FY. And he'll transition in that greedy kind of full position core hero that we've seen him be, but
I'm not sure that was necessary. But FY just wants
he's
to make
zoning.
Sure. Yeah, don't last hit. Yeah, get back to your town.
And Timbersaw is very much a hero we don't see at all because of how farm and level dependent he is. It's an offlane hero that needs probably the most farm and levels of any offlaner out there, and that's just where this hero fell off. And he also doesn't work well in dual lanes because of how much experience and levels he needs. They're diving, top lane.
Committing onto Puppy. They're not really focusing one hero down now. Ice trying to deal with the disruptor while FY looks to go on the Shadow Fiend, and because of it, they're going to end up giving up the first one, but they get the double for Ice. Great turn there.
Yep.
It looked a little dicey, Gods.
Acceptable.
Winter wanted stronger lanes. Doom,
got it.
So good. Even from the jungle, he gives you stronger lanes.
Absolutely. It kind of looks greedy on paper, but they're not going to play it in that fashion. Secret probably going to be happy and lucky to just get the first blood there, but ultimately a VG Gaming win. Timbersaw, I talked about how level and farm dependent he can be, and getting a double kill to start things off. Both solo kills as well give him a huge early game boost to his experience.
It's level 4 here, even outranking Misery in that regard as he pushes in the lane. So quickly checking in on the bottom lane, Burning has been running from Ion Shell. It's still last hitting okay early on, but they take a lot of harass. Normally we do see that Soul Ring picked up nice and early for some additional regen. Is why is going to pass off into the jungle. So he heads away from the top lane. He's going to relieve a little pressure here on the Shadow Fiend Disruptor, who are both still level 3 in their own right. So it's not like they're struggling too much for their levels early on. As Weeha can move into the jungle now. He's got the two Meepos and the level... It's only the level 1 poop, so not particularly adept at the jungling, but for now...
Just wanted to fall back so he can make sure he made his stack timing and to kind of ensure the later game farm. Even when I've seen Weeha get pressured, he still sometimes will find like a 13, 14 minute Aghanim Scepter just by efficient jungle play.
And of course, with the Lich mid, you're going to get a lot of experience for your team this way.
Super for now, winning the mid lane, out-CSing the Meepo despite versing a dual lane, but we'll suffer a lot in the experience department because of the spam coming out from the Dark Ritual.
With the departure of FY from the top lane.
Oh, he's back.
An emboldened little window here for Eternal Envy, but boy, it's here to end it.
Yep.
Devour back online again. It's still a skill point being reserved here so far for Ice Ice Ice. Has not opted for any points in Whirling Death yet. Trying to figure out if he can get a kill before he skills up.
And taking a lot of harass here, really needs more HP before they go for that dive. They want to try and put pressure on Envy, and that is tower, he's very vulnerable. I think always keep in mind his TP rotations, and of all the heroes that have one, it's actually Meepo. Recognizing what's going on at top lane, has picked up an early teleport just to be able to punish the kind of dives we just saw out of VG Gaming.
Yeah, he has gotten that point in Earth by now, so there's some kill potential here for anyone caught out of position, and Invis will be grabbed by the Dazzle. Fenrir moves on towards mid. Weeha now level 5. Level 3 Poof comes into play, and this is where the burst damage really starts to pick up for the Meepos.
Yeah. It feels like they can't apply as much pressure anymore because Ice 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 has been consistently kind of below half HP, but...
FY is tanking some nukes. He's only got the level 1 Scorched Earth. He's going to have to rank it up to 2. And now, Ray is still cooling down. 1 second. Not going to have it in time. Ice 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 kind of watches it all on the trees, but he can't really get into position to assist there. Blinks, the other big farm winner so far, is Burning, is up to 26 and 8. Checked all the cores farming well, except for one gods. Ice 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 really having a bad time in the offlane. He got the early double kill, but his CS, a measly 7. And almost 5 minutes in.
Yeah, Secret's lanes have very much stabilized right now, and they're getting the farm advantage. They're stacking their jungle. And I feel like VG Gaming definitely need to make a move fairly soon. Try and go for a kill on someone like the Meepo mid lane when Viper hits level 6. They can't just sit back and naturally farm.
Here we go!
Never mind. A bit tanky. I think if anyone can change the tempo of this game, it may actually be Burning hitting level 6 and doing what we saw like Fear do a lot of on Klinks during TI, which is just going for those early rotations. Then you can just give the safe lane to the Dazzle. Dazzle is not an aggressive roaming hero. Just a hero you can have sit bottom lane with a TP. Should a dive happen under a tower, you TP in for a grave, but you want Klinks getting active as early as possible this game.
Yeah, it's certainly not going to be the Doom who does it moving forward. He had the nice start top, but level 3 here on FY as he swings back towards the top lane. And it's also a Viper Gods, another hero who really can't pressure the map, which means it does really feel like it's got to be the Klinks for now and maybe the Doom later control the tempo of this game. Goes Poof back on mid. Send one down towards the bottom rune. Bounty rune for Weeha, now level 6. Gonna pull ahead here and, well, both cores farming. Unconventional heroes, especially the Shadow Fiend safe lane secret, but they're working out.
And for VG Gaming, very much just waiting for a couple kind of key level timings here. Pylai Dai could be in some trouble.
Scorched Earth activated, but Pylai Dai backing Viper off into the trees. He's trying to tango his way through. He's got two more. He panics. He eats the trees, but it's not the right ones. And down he goes. A much-needed additional kill. Still, though, the cores are farming on Secret.
Yeah, and VG Gaming very much pushing for that game 5, but needing to do more right now to prevent these cores from just snowballing. And that's Meepo, who's already continuing to stack the jungle. He's got a quad stack, about to be a 5 stack here, and there is no punish in sight.
Yeah, like you said, you'd love to see the Klinks here, but there's nobody laning bottom. Fenrir, from the Klinks, Fenrir currently stacking the jungle.
Here comes Ice Ice Ice, though.
Potentially 4 Ice Ice Ice.
And this is where Meepo has to be very careful. They're pinging this out. They're bringing everyone.
Pi could be in danger here. Ice Ice Ice. Level 5, but only 2 points in the chain. He's going to try to steal it. He jumps in. A bold maneuver. Will it get punished? The super also rotate in. The whole Secret squad are here to party. But first, they're going to lose the Disruptor. Now Super trying to run, but if he runs, he may get caught by Raze on the way out. Envy going to get the trade, and now FY could be next. Even Misery joining the fight. They need Burning here. He's just farming away off in the jungle. The Dazzle not going to help out while that was going on. Ice 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 did manage to run another Shadow Fiend, but back to FY, who will be finished off as well. So they lose 2 big cores there, Gods. Though they do manage to at least bring down the Shadow Fiend. Didn't catch who got most of the creeps there.
Yeah, it looked like a pretty even as far as the kills go, and other neutrals being at least contested by VG Gaming. But if they bring the Klinks in there, I feel like they win that heavily.
I think they get like 2 or 3 more kills there.
Could have TP'd towards the mid lane and then gone for a Skeleton Walk initiation. He'd already rotated into the jungle, giving Dazzle the safe lane. That's where Fenrir's hit level 5 now, but just not quite all the heroes they needed to be there. Maybe Burning feeling like if he rotates and doesn't get anything out of it, it's going to be a really big hit to his farm and item progression, but now we see him rotate. He's top. looking for a pickoff, although a bit low on mana, has strafe and only a couple searing arrows.
Thanks, does a lot of damage at this stage. It's only going to take like 5-ish arrows or so to bring Puppy down, but Puppy seems to be wise to it. He did have the sentry in the lane. Still the arrows coming in, hot and heavy, and Burning gets on the board. Finds his first kill. We'll see if they can transition that into a push. Darkseer is now occupied mid, and Weeha, you mentioned he likes to move around a lot early, guys, if he sees openings, and he is FY at the same time, trying to bully. Envy back a little bit. Fenrir's here, the Requiem comes out. Envy trying to take this fight. He knows that Weeha's coming in. FY diving forward, now looks to run the next there. FY gets caught. Poof! No, the Grave might be enough to save him. Another net. Another net finds him, and now FY will go down in the end.
Yeah.
Good patience there by Weeha.
Still okay as far as Vici are concerned. They get the top T1 tower. A bit over-aggressive from FY, but it was very much the surprise factor that was Weeha's Meepo rocking up. And for Vici, they're slowly kind of taking objectives, getting farm across the board, and Secret very much kind of at a weak point in their lineup where if they want to take fights, they've got to bring in, like, the extra number. That's where Meepo had to rotate for some extra pressure, and...
Oh, Puppy. Doesn't even have the boots yet. He's so vulnerable to this aggression, and Burning's gonna do it again! One more auto-attack gets the job done! You wanted the aggression from Burning Gods, and you are getting it. And last game, we did see that second stage ban on the Klinks. Secret.
Yep.
This hero, they respected what Burning can do with it, and he's showing why.
Yeah, and just very much Secret just not quite ready to take fights, even go for smoke ganks. They need the Darkseer mech, I feel, is a key item, and the level 6 on their supports. Both Lich and Disruptor get a lot stronger with their ultimates, and Vici Gaming just having the early game edge for now.
For now, but Meepo is farming. Still, the Shadow Fiend doing very well. Eternal Envy could be next on the list, although he's got 9 armor and 1,000 health. He's not all that squishy.
Not a solo kill for Klinks.
Burning's gonna need a plus one for that.
Yeah. With a Desolator.
Doesn't even have the max Searing Arrows right
now. Yeah. Could be different with something like a Deso, but not on the cards right now. And he'll just grab a rune, head back up towards the top jungle, and wait for maybe some backup from his team. But right now, he can kind of be the one applying pressure, farming the Dire Jungle, taking away farm from Secret. And it seems Vici just happy to play more of an economy game now. They've got much more farm going their way, all 3 lanes, their own jungle, and some of the Dire jungle. Secret just forced to play very scared because of Burning's movements over the last couple of minutes.
They had an Observer Ward here. They know that Burning's in the neighborhood. He's going to go on to Envy. The backup's coming in, though. Puppy looking to turn, and he might get this kill anyway. No! What auto-attack! He's just short. Secret. Oh. They baited the trap beautifully.
Ice.
They walk away on top. They might even lose. Ice. He's gonna look for a kill. Shading through onto Weeha, but does he have the follow-up burst damage? You bring that Chakram back. Pi just standing and delivering another chain through. It's gonna be close. Chakram gets one. But that's not really worth it.
That's a dominating streak going to Weeha's Meepo. Flashy play from Ice. Gets the kill as he goes down, but
You would love to see like that plus one hero that can really gank effectively right now.
That was a solo Timbersaw smoke, which just doesn't... That's not like a strategic play. That was very much Ice just seeing how low SF was like, oh, I'm going to try do something unpredictable and flashy, but it wasn't like... That was Vici Gaming just looking for an individual play rather than a team play, which is what they need to do right now, considering their lineup is peaking. They did have a bit of a lead. They don't need to go for those kind of kills to like maintain their lead right now.
Weeha now also going to grab his Ogre Club. The Aghanim's build-up continues. Although Burning has done a pretty good job of shutting down some of these other heroes, the Meepo remains 2-0-0. A little bit under-leveled for what you generally see at this point, but he has been roaming a lot, God. It's not like that kind of classic just ultra jungle mode, as Envy's been the guy mostly taking up the jungle.
And Envy with a decent amount of farm here, we'll have to see what he gets with his 2,000 gold. SMY rush possible, although he's banking up money as if he may go for even something like a Blink Dagger, but... Don't really feel a Blink Rush is the name of the game here for Team
even
Secret.
Even like that Weeha as Shadowblade maybe to try and set up ganks with the Meepo?
Shadowblade's good, they haven't got lockdown to really control you, so it just gives you that extra bit of mobility which can't be punished because of the lack of lockdown.
As quickly as they got near a 3k gold lead. Back down to 1k for Vici. It's an even game, Gods, heading towards the mid game. The analysts talked at length about the team fight of Secret even before the boat pick. And he's actually very scary in the team fights with the AoE poofs. So they're going to be hard pressed to take these 5v5s, I feel. Burning pokes out his head and he gets scouted.
Both teams very much waiting their timings. The Viper mech's not complete just yet, and I think that's going to be where VG Gaming make the more kind of strategic move, which will be grouping up for like 2-3-man smoke gank, have Klinks just off on his own, like creating chaos around the map, but you can't just idly like farm and sit back right now. Otherwise, Meepo is going to take control of this game.
The egg's almost complete now, just needs one component, 450 to go, and Envy continues to bank up gold. Feels like it almost has to be the Shadowblade at this point.
We'll find out in just a second here. Almost has the money for it. Burning just scouting out the Ancients, make sure that there's no stacks going on, trying to get his team as much intel as possible. Has created room for the FY Doom to just farm up a Midas now, and yep, there's the Shadowblade.
Alright. Taking a page out of Weeha's book. This will be the aggression kicking in, and right when the Doom is getting a Midas, they're very close to completing their mech gods. They get the Shadowblade, they get the mech. The Meepo eggs about to come online. Secret are definitely going to hit a timing here. Question is, will Vici be ready for it? They have their own mech, so that will help. Still, heroes like Timbersaw doesn't really have much in the way of farm at this point. Doesn't have that big cleated Bloodstone or other item that lets him engage early. Vici actually take these head-on collisions.
And now they're going to be the ones who look to get the jump, and I think that's a key thing here. If Vici can start the fight and force Secret to be TP rotating, they may be able to get a pick off or two before Secret even are ready to back
heroes
up.
They're moving mid, Pylai Dai scrambling back, Ice, looking for the jump here to try and finish up Pylai Dai. Throws out the Shockwave, will end up going down, but the trade may be there as they drop the wall, the Meepos are coming, no, they get blasted! Blown up by Burning, who was ready to assist. Just not quite tanky enough yet, even with that eggs. Well, they may not have control, but something you and I were discussing while the draft was going on is Vici have a lot of just burst damage, so if the Meepos are out of position and they just get caught right next to the Klinks while he's death packed, they can drop very, very quickly.
And very much the time of the game where Meepo is at his weakest against Timbersaw. Timbersaw's just hit level 11, so we're looking at, well, I guess he's still just got the level 1 Chakram, maybe a misclick from Ice, but maxed out Whirling Death and Timber Chain. Klinks, just with the max Searing Chains, level 2 death pack, doesn't even have a Desolator yet, which I believe will be his first item. Needs to be careful here at bottom.
Envy, no, it's a creep.
Not sure if that was...
That's not the play. Doesn't look like he wants the kill, though. He's just going to back off. Not really worried about burning. Chase him, as you can always make that TP out if need be.
Yeah. And this is where the one probably reason why Vici maybe weren't expecting a Meepo is because running the Meepo with an SF is definitely a bit of a weak point in your life where you've got these two greedy heroes looking at a lot of farm. Normally you see the Meepo played with something that's more of a space creator for Envy, more of a fighting type core rather than a farming one like the Shadow Fiend.
Yeah, like say a Gyro, for example, something that was on the docket. It was discussed as potentially a burning hero, definitely something Envy can play. Decided to throw the curveball here. Things settled down now a bit. Vici Gaming with a comfortable 3,000-ish gold and experience lead is... Tice is getting closer to that Bloodstone, and perhaps equally importantly, close to the level 2 Chakram. That's where things start to get very scary for the Meepo. Before he gets that next big stats item that really beefs him up.
Yeah, and I feel very much now is the time where Vici Gaming can go for another smoke gank like they just did. That one was just so well executed because it was right by the T1 mid tower. So they catch Secret by surprise from behind, then get the T1 mid. Possibly a smoke towards bottom where they can follow it up with the T1 tower could be a good move, and Secret...
Oh, gods, look at this.
Yeah.
Burning, this is the way that he likes to play the Klinks. Yes. Unlike Fear, he rushes BKB, he's done a few times this tournament. They have basically nothing on BKB. Even for the Meepos, the Geo Strike, that too is, I believe, magic damage well. So you basically have no right click aside from the Shadow Fiend.
Are they going to get here in time? It looks like they might LD.
This could be ugly for Secret. They're really committed to this one. Ice is going to be the first man in. Drops the Chakra. Static Storm is going to be there, but FY swings around. He's looking to jump in. The Roche drops low. They're going to have to fight it out soon. Burning, swarming around. BKB goes, and he lets loose a puppy. Brings him down fast. Turns onto Misery. Chokes him down as well. Now they're in the pit. He might be able to finish up Pi 2. He is slowed down. Weeha going to go down once. Can they get him a second time?
Brings Piper down, so I think Vici actually has to back off here, so...
They do get rid of the Aegis. It's a 2-for-2.
A big gamble, but it pays off the
shabby.
Secret. Yeah, they got one core hero, the Doom essentially a core with how much farm he's gotten.
Burning had a moment there where he could have gotten that third kill in the pit on the Lich, but at the same time, it does ensure that they take down the Aegis.
So they get there, like, 3 seconds sooner, I think Secret just get team wiped.
Also, if they just had that hero to easily start the fight, like you have to run in and throw a shock grenade. It's not the best initiation.
And you're running into the Lich Chain Frost. That Chain Frost really kind of pushed Vici Gaming back. They had to split up. They weren't really positioning in ideal ways. And we'll see what Vici Gaming look to get done now. They just used the smoke for that. I'm sure they have some more left. And with Bloodstone complete, I think they want to keep on taking fights. They know that Weehouse Meepo doesn't have an Aegis to play around with. Likely to complete the Blink Dagger soon, but they've got great items for being able to fight into the Meepo with the Klink's BKB, with Timbersaw having a Bloodstone complete now.
He gets the blink now, can definitely look to partner up with Misery. Got the Arcane Boots, we'll see what he wants to pick up here next, but they are going to take this opportunity to smoke, and they have done a spot of D-warding, trying to find that Klink's as he moves through the dire jungle. Where do they go, gods? The blink Meepo heading towards bottom, while the rest of the gang...
Very much want to find a pick-off, not a big team fight, because if they run into someone like a Klink's or a Timbersaw, and V Gaming have four or five heroes there, I think Secret will struggle to win a team fight.
Fission not the best now, but they are hanging back very far. Arming up some Ancients with the Klink's. FY, who did opt for Midas, we never really mentioned it, but to point it out, Secret, they made their deep move in. But it seems FY may have scouted Puppy walking down the ramp.
Yeah, pinging the exact cliff. Either saw him or just Spidey senses.
He may have taken a step down, but either way, they... Secret have just been gone so long at this point. They're gonna show, reveal, Envy bottom lane is... Let's continue towards the Yasha now. Looks like the SMY will be the build-up, so... Very much mirroring how Weehaw likes to play the hero. I imagine for Burning, we will see that Desolator they talked about, and... Going back to the last time Burning played Klink's, I believe it was versus Ehome in the lower bracket finals gods. When he got the Desolator, they had one fight where he just won them the game. He got like a triple or an ultra kill with the BKB, totally caught Ehome off guard, and they could never bounce back for that fight, so... Definitely something Secret need to be careful about, especially considering just how good BKB is this game.
Looking to bait out Burning's BKB here, but he's not taking the bait.
Nice patient health. Yeah. You gotta commit the Meepos if you wanna go
yes,
for that.
If Meepo blinks in, he'll BKB and then Meepo's dead, so... Burning, not fooled by any of Puppy's shenanigans.
Yeah, still a good effort though. Sometimes players just panic. So Isis split pushing up to still only 8 Bloodstone charges, but was his announced Boots of Travel, and this could be a really big item for Secret. Are gonna grab Darkseer Blink Dagger. So with the blink, they now have that instant initiation. Goes great with the disruptor potentially. Could be what starts the team fight.
Isis has been spotted here up top to see if he gets caught out as a result. But yeah, he's just going to go in for the wave anyway, so... It's like he'll farm it out and then just back off. But Vici Gaming bringing in backup Klink's and Doom at the ready as well.
These have not been scouted out. Burning, he can just dive a tower if he wants and get a pretty much free kill on Puppy, but he wants something bigger.
Yeah, that would be like you'd force a BKB TP just to get out, which may not be worth it.
I've also gone for Link on FY, so... The initiation that Vici was lacking, perhaps they have it now, gods.
Yeah. Trying to bait out this top lane. They can get kills so quickly here with the Klink's Timbersaw.
And while they're doing that, Secret are trying to bait out bottom. The Meepo is just chilling.
I mean, these teams are very much on the same page strategically as far as what they want to do, how to execute their kind of mid-game strategies, and very much it's the exact same thing on both sides. Waiting to
it's
see heroes on the map.
It's actually kind of adorable how long they've both been waiting.
And they showed the one here, it's the exact same hero. Ice, the offlaner, pushing out the lane, willing to risk his life. And at bottom, it's Misery, iron shelling the wave, pushing it out. As they wait for someone to appear, and it will be Super at bottom.
He's the mech bearer. I don't know if that's the one you want to be tower diving.
Meanwhile, top, Dire Vision now there. They've gone for what normally is a ward you wouldn't expect to see from the Dire team, but very much recognizing the threat. Vici Gaming posing for this top lane, and it's kind of paired up with a sentry ward, so you can get some detection of the Klink's when he's roaming up near that tier 2 tower, trying to go for the flank. A very common flank to make by a Klink's is to get behind the tier 2 top tower and try and kill off the supports who think they're safe and hiding.
Well, the Meepos, right when they're about to pounce top, they poof away, and on the back of an Envy double damage rune, they are going to take the tier 2 bottom. They really want to force these
Vici
TPs back.
Burning has no TP. He's got a... Run to the secret shop soon, and Puppy's ready to cancel TPs.
They pop down a weave. Puppy in position here. Ice. Isn't quite in the vision, the long range lob. Just off the mark and burning. He's not going to TP. He's going to sprint down.
Yeah. If the TP if you cancel the Timber's TP, they may have committed bottom lane. Would have been a 3v3. But still a good amount of damage dealt to the tier 3 tower by Secret. Ultimately not a big objective, though, or something that's going to help transition them into this mid-game stage.
Oh, gods. It's been a pretty slow mid-game here. What do you see as the upcoming timings for both teams?
For Vici,
is there a key item or ability that they're lacking?
A lot of BKBs for Vici is probably going to be needed against Lich, Darkseer, and Meepo. And for Secret, it's very much they're happy to play the farm game. Burning's found Lich here.
Misery, the quick blink out, but meanwhile Burning, finding kills in the mid lane. The BKB does its magic, and they will get two. Now he's going to fight against the Meepos, though. They hack him down. They might get Ice. So Weeha starting to heat up in the midst of this fight. Chaining to the high ground. There's no teleport scroll here on Ice. As it is still pulling down. He's going to go back in. He's committing onto Weeha, and he's got some support. They poop all around. The Glimmer Cape's there, and the Meepo gets shut down. While that was happening, they also ended up losing the Darkseer. He eventually burned down to the Doom. So a 4-for-1 around the map.
Burning just willing to throw away his life for the greater good. This is such a different Burning to what people know of him from the past, where he's just going and engaging, bringing down a Lich and Shadow Fiend, knows that he can't fight the Meepo because he used his entire BKB duration for the first two kills, but the fight's already won by that point, so he dies, but his team, they reap the rewards.
Burning that Desolator about to come online now. He's got the recipe on the courier, but forget about the Desolator. They're looking for kills mid. They're going to chuck out the Shocker and Puppy. Maybe trying to bait heroes in as those cores are very close to respawning. Glimpse will connect on Fenrir. Glimmer, they're going to drop a sentry for this. He keeps running back. FY trying to protect his old friend, but that is not going to happen. Could have gone for the grave there. Probably dies anyway. It looks like VG still want to take this fight, though. They're jumping onto Misery. The massive damage from Ice. And he chunks down the Disruptor on the back of the fight. Getting the most out of the Timbersaw. There's a reason why he's one of the few players that actually have pro gear for this hero. It's because he used to play the hell out of it.
13 Bloodstone charges. Already has a BKB as well. The most farmed hero almost being the Timbersaw on the Radiant side. Just a little bit behind the Klingsin.
Until the Meepo gets
this
that
scary.
It's like almost impossible to really do anything to him.
Weeha
has the Dust Gods. They're hunting and a Bindy. No teleport. The rat tactics will be shut down. And Vici begin to extend their advantage. Now up 8k gold, 5k experience. Feels like all they really need now is perhaps a gem and some deep wards, and they'll be in full control of this game number 4.
And again, it's kind of selfless play from Burning. He just makes sure he picks up a Dust, has it for the team. Happened last fight as well, where SF gets caught out by surprise by the Klink's Dust. And again, this time, he knew about it this time, but Burning very much prepared. He immediately buys a new Dust. Say, this is the way to kill Envy, shut down his greed.
They're just early. They're going to poke their heads in the pit. They don't have that great hero to just constantly give vision. Dazzle, yeah, he can ult, but pretty substantial cooldown. They might just miss out on this Roche. As it turns out, I think it would be a
really by a sentry
back
here.
With the Alpha Wolf and the Deso, this will be very quick. FY, is he going to wait for it? Yeah, he is. All right. I've seen so many of those games where the player leaves the pit and then the Roche respawns, and you just never know, but they're going to chunk this one down. Burning. A lot of damage here at the Desolator, and it doesn't seem like Secret have any interest in contesting, although they have a smoke. Position is not right for them.
No idea what's going on. They're not even split pushing top lane because they're afraid that Beachy Gaming may be laying a trap there and burning now with Aegis in hand.
He's telling Fenrir, carry my dust plan, but
no one takes
no inventory slots.
Well, this is you want the dust on him, but I guess deciding that all his other item pickups are just as valuable. And
I mean, like you said, FY doesn't support anymore. He's like, why am I carrying this? I should be getting items, real items.
It's very much been a game of four cores for Vici Gaming. You look at their overall strategy, every single game, FY is up there with 10k plus net worth by mid-game. And it's been the same for Secret. Puppy's played a greedy support role, but this is the first game where, because of the Klink's pick, because of how much he got done early on with his aggression, Secret don't have that farmed up support, and that's where they're really struggling here in the mid-game.
I really like this gem pickup. As long as they hang on to it, Burning. Let's see Weeha, but knows that he
needs
can't stop
backup.
That poof out. He needs more burst or some lockdown.
Ice on the perfect position to detect that smoke, but doesn't look
you know,
like they
we talked a lot about how... Oh, Burning. He is going to go on Weeha, but see you later.
Just going to be careful. No TP. And, okay, skeleton walk in
but,
5 seconds.
But you know, guys, we talked ice, moving in, and, oh, little Shadow Blade away. About how there's just no lockdown on VG Gaming. Yeah, they have Doom, but not really great control. Secret have zero stuns as well. They've got Vacuum, you know, they've got ways to interrupt TPs, but they don't have proper disables. Until they get the Hex on the Darkseer or the Meepo, and that feels like it could be a long way off. Actually, the Meepo Hex is not too far.
And very much an item that can be very easily countered by Linkers. One of the problems with Meepo when you're going around looking for the kills, you get this small window where you've got a Hex that can go on someone like a Timbersaw, go on someone like a Klinks, but once if they want to farm up a Linkers to prevent that, you've got no items which can break it until you then farm a Diffusal Blade as well, so... It gets trickier and trickier for Meepo as this game drags on, and still just feeling too squishy this game. Just the 2k HP against the Timber Klinks burst damage is not going to cut it.
Well, do you have a clear favorite if this goes late as is? If it's a bit of a Vici Gaming lead right now, Gons?
It's going to remain.
Do you think Secret can fight them?
I think right now it's going to remain a Vici Gaming lead. They've got the gem, they'll get map control, they'll keep the lanes pushed out, starve out Secret in their base, so... It's going to go late game, and it's going to be very Vici Gaming favored because of the lead they've already established, which is kind of going to play into their game plan. Rather than looking to close out the game with a big push, they're just going to look to keep getting further and further ahead and keep Secret bottled up in their base. If anyone leaves, you jump them, you take a pick off, or if Secret five-man, then you just split push and use your kind of farming efficiency to go better into the late game. Very much a lineup with supports, cores, all of which can go a lot in terms of items. 40, 50 minutes in the game. It doesn't really feel like Vici's lineup is going to fall off at any point.
Yeah, the BKB out now for Super's Viper. Ashiva's online for the Doom. So we now see triple BKB. The Secret's still lacking any way to handle it. Burning, haunting, he's got the Aegis for 2 minutes. But he wants a little backup. That Frost Armor is quite annoying when you're trying to find these
and
kills.
And Ghost Scepter. It's very much, you may just feed your life away here if you're not careful.
He's gonna punish Puppy on the TP out. Oh, we'll make it. Pops the Ghost Scepter there at the last moment. Ice just hacks away at the tower. Envy's like, I really want to Requiem this, but it's only gonna tickle. Does force out the BKB. He tries to throw up the Chakra. He has to Bloodstone to die. Ice gets a wee bit cocky, but FY's gonna look to punish. Now Flicky with the Doom, the Shivas as well. Envy probably going down here as well. Glimpse back by Puppy, the mech up by Misery. Great defensive play. And it looks like with Weeha also arriving, they're gonna get the Ice kill. Granted, it was a suicide. And they get Envy out.
Rare mistake from Ice. Like, normally a clutch, mechanically skilled player, but that was, it was very slow in the Timber Chain escape there. Would have been fine.
Yeah, I think he underestimated the damage output from the Shadow Fiend. Maybe didn't expect the crit.
Yeah.
Which came out, but still good play to pop the suicide because that last auto attack would have definitely killed him.
And we'll see Vici Gaming. Looks like they'll try and take this bottom tier on tower. Already very low and with Super in the front lines. Should be a very straightforward pickup.
Yeah, the Aegis is still in line here for about a minute. Ice now heading towards the top lane. That was also his 10-second BKB. Against a Meepo, these charges are ever so precious. Looks like they may want to try to jump him. He's chained himself in. All the Meepo poofs off the mark. Ice. BKB is still not ready for 10 seconds, and they know it. They're looking to punish the Nets. They keep on stacking. We can't Bloodstone tonight. Chains away. No. It's a futile jab. Secret just understanding the BKB timing perfectly, and only now, just now, Gods does pull down.
Yeah. And Vici Gaming, even without Ice, can potentially still threaten this bottom lane, but doesn't feel like they're interested when they can kind of get a bit more farm, fall back, and costly pickoffs from Ice has kind of given Secret a bit of a second life here in game number four. Radiant structures are fortified. And for Secret, those are the kind of pickoffs which will be kind of their bread and butter as far as turning this game around. They're just going to take whatever kind of heroes out of position and just take those pickoffs and move on. This now new pickup for Meepo also going to help find pickoffs. Means he doesn't necessarily need the backup to go for the solo kills.
Well, this could be the BKB counter. That Blink Hex and burst somebody down. Viper, maybe not the easiest kill, but potentially your Klinks could fall to this, Gods. We'll see.
Both of them very tanky. Once Klinks has a death backed up, but
yeah.
Now both teams trading towers across the map. We've seen and talked about this time and time again. Always finding trade. We never see, apart from maybe game three where Secret got a massive lead early on and there was nothing Vici could do.
Ooh. Burning with the Diffusal Blade.
Great pickup against the Ghost Scepter.
Yeah. Flips back onto Super. Net coming out. Will Billy connect? Do they want to engage? Though he's got the BKB. Seems like they at least want to force it. And now it's Envy. He runs in and he explodes. And that has the buyback. He did force out a lot of BKBs here. It's not all bad, but
yeah,
they even committed
BKBs.
A Doom there.
They were canceling his Rec'em. I don't think they needed to commit as many BKBs as they did.
Glimpse number two. This time, no BKB. There is a mech available. The wall gets dropped, discouraging any kind of save. They back in Fenrir. Over the Static Storm, he's silenced. He can't get off the grave. They're going to lose the Viper. They're going to lose the Dazzle. They're also going to lose the Gem.
And they do all of that without the Eternal End back. Fantastic play from Secret. Knowing the BKBs were on cooldown, all they needed was to get a glimpse and Vici just get drawn in.
Well, these BKBs, that was the big power peak for Vici Gaming. Not to say they fall off now, but we just haven't seen them really get to use them in the most efficient way. Secret Puppy in particular, catching them out of position time and again.
Still
reset here around 34 minutes. It's a healthy Vici Gaming lead still now.
Yep.
12k gold, 8k experience, but it does feel a bit like the momentum has shifted back.
Yes, shifted a lot. A lot of it just coming from, I mean, it feels like Vici Gaming need to be more polished right now with their just overall execution and the team fight selection. I don't actually think Secret's going to be the stronger late game team per se. Meepo not known for his ability to scale, and Kraven to late game. Top, Burning's there waiting, it's a bait!
Oh dear.
What a bait.
He sees the free kill, except not. That's painful.
Yeah. That was very smart from BG.
And he's dead for 80. As it turns out, he doesn't actually have the buyback. This could be ugly. Envy, though, should be okay against Bernie. No detection up on him right now. Can always Shadow Blade away. He gets chunked down the courier, though. No, nothing on it. I'll take that.
It's 1400 HP creep, too. I'm going to take what you can hope for.
Their sentry is in position now. Bernie going to run past it, but Bai just wants to run the hell away, and the team is streaming down. If they want to force out this Meepo buyback, try to make something of that previous kill. Glimpsey back, burning anything to slow down the incoming push, but it's only going to be a few seconds before he arrives. And the Timbersaw is pushing in the top lane. Vici are quickly going to realize that Meepo doesn't have the buyback,
even
trying to cut the tower, doing every kind of Envy. But meanwhile, FY's jumped in. He's doomed out, Puppy. Glimmer Cape looking to keep him alive and force him back to the well.
Can they get
safely, but still Vici taking a lane of Rax, trying to force that. Deciding in five. They're looking for a second one. Now they move on to top lane. They've got a lot of firepower here. The BKBs are still available.
Oh, 10 seconds. It rushed to the top lane. They could have definitely got a tier 3 tower and gotten out, but a tier 3 tower ultimately not as big as getting a rack, so it's not worth risking it, and they'll fall back now. One lane already taken, though, puts Vici Gaming to a fantastic position, and now Roshan respawning. Everything seems to be timing together perfectly for the Vici Gaming squad.
Are they going to go scout it?
Still, the gem has transferred hands. I think it's time for Vici to pick up a new one. Very much a key item to deal with the Shadow Blade and just general map control issues, but it's still a minute before it comes back in stock, and as a result, without much map control, Secret may feel confident to actually take the Roche for themselves, and Vici not in a position to contest.
Tower will go down mid as gets killed off by creeps, but the real objective is that Roche pit, and although they pin it out with Link's cons, it looks like they will be too late. Do they fight? Not even close. Everybody back near the tier 2 bottom, so Secret, despite what looked like a pretty awful turn, they do grab the Aegis and the cheese now for Eternal Envy. Is this enough for them to take a fight?
I really don't feel it is. You've got, for me, Vici Gaming having 5-second BKBs hurts a bit against the Meepo, but for me, the situation with Meepo is you either burst him down when he's in the fight instantly and then Vici win the fight, or if they can't burst him down, you lose the fight, whether it's a 5-second BKB or a longer BKB. And very much, it's all about dodging the Requiem damage when it comes to these BKBs. So if you time it such that it's coming out with the Requiem, you're going to stay alive. Or it gets you out of a Disruptor Ultimate / Glimpse. You don't need a long or a short, it doesn't matter whether it's a long or a short BKB for those situations. So I think Secret are still going to be forced to play somewhat defensively. And we can see here, Vici say, you took Aegis and Cheese, we don't really care. We're just going to go actually smoke right at you.
They've got the double chakram now. Ice has picked up his eggs, and they're going to look to make their jump in. FY, he will pop the Dust of Doom onto Eternal Envy, but Envy sprinting back towards the base. Puppy, nice Ghost Scepter, bro, says burning his hole. Immediately purge it off. Gets the kill. There's no buyback on the Disruptor Gods. That's also the gem back.
Yep.
You mentioned wanting to buy a new one. They'll collect theirs and take it right back.
And zero BKB committed. Very disciplined from Vici with the pickoff. Unfortunately, the Doom goes on cooldown, so I'm not sure they'll continue to push here.
4K up now onto Burning, looking for that next item. It's Ice, Ice, Ice. Oh god, look at the damage the Meepos are taking! Almost dead off the path! Barely retreating to the well, my god. Okay,
super.
They've got a Timbersaw problem.
Okay, he'll get that.
All chain cross
to cancel it. Nicely done by Pi.
Yeah. They do 130 HP on one of those Meepos there.
I mean, he pretty much killed all four of them. That was just ugly.
How do you deal with that as a Meepo? He just... He's just nowhere near that next big HP item.
Yeah, you... And I don't even know if going HP... There's only so much HP you can get on the hero since you only get the plus strength on your clone, so...
Yeah.
If anything, I feel like you're better just going more... I mean, I say Glass Cannon, you still got 2k plus HP on Meepo. Going for the Diffusal or the Ethereal Blade, just going for pure Agi, it helps you split push better, it helps you wrap, it helps you also just get kills in fights, not to mention just giving you some extra utility. If they go for a Lincolns, you've got the Diffusal or the E-Blade to take him out, and I think just going DPS is going to be the way to play this one. Oh, Burning!
Oh, that's good pop. They got off the Hex Initiation, and now Burning in a bit of trouble, but Grave Dump is going to BKB and lays onto Weeha. Will pop the Aegis. Maybe we'll go down the second time, though, as Ice, Ice, Ice forced to turn tail and run Burning. In the back out, they have a glimpse available, and Ice, Ice, Ice leads them on a merry chase around the world. He will make it out in the end.
Yep, the Klink's BKB for the Aegis, while your Viper's dead, very much plays into Vici Gaming's hands here.
But they have the Doom up again.
BKB is on cooldown, though, and Vici Gaming really need to fight around these.
See, FY, he barely clips Puppy. He could Doom this, and he will Doom this. Level Death follows it up as well. The Kinetic Field well placed to protect...
That's
Capitan, but looks like he is still doomed.
We're not looking at the new patch
yet. Blinks the wrong way. Yeah, sad way to die. Puppy, completely abandoned by his friends and family, goes down again.
40 seconds on the sideline now.
But the lane's not really that pushed in, Gods. Not sure if they can get that second lane of Rex yet.
Really dangerous time to be fighting, though. Envy, without buyback money on the SF, may look to farm it. And bottom lane, Burning is actually looking for the pickup. All he needs is a TP from someone with a disable, that being the Doom. Doom's the only disable they've got.
Oh, he pooped forward onto the wave. He's in a lot of trouble now. Weeha getting chunked down by Burning. Slayed again. And it is really starting to feel like this Meepo is just not going to be able to pull Secret across the finish line, Gods.
I was looking at that, I was like, okay, all Burning needs is one disable. I'm like, wait, who's the disable? I guess Doom is. Level Death is the best disable they've got.
Yeah. And then they make he makes it easy and just poofs forward, so.
Even with that, if he tried to poof escape, the Level Death cancel probably would have been enough to get the kill still. And now Secret. Gonna be in trouble defending high ground. They have a Meepo buyback to fall back on, but... Vici Gaming very much intent on forcing that out.
And as though Burning didn't have enough damage, now he grabs a Daedalus. Even more bursts coming his way. The Doom is cooling down.
Not for long.
They're going to look to break the base. Chakram flies out. Secret. A loss here puts us on a deciding game number 5. This one could well go the distance. They're going to need big plays out of Misery. Look for the back wall. The Chakram's dissuading any sort of jump in. And now the Doom. FY is going to take out the big teamfight specialist from this fight. Misery counters with his own Chivas. But already the tower's down. There's the back. The wall as well. Pretty well placed. But my god, that heal bomb from Fenrir just slaughtered him where he stood. And now they're chasing on Envy. The BKB is protecting the Burning. Again, Fenrir with the plays. The Grave. And more damage. They will lose their Quakes, but it's too late. Deciding game number 5.
What a time to pull out a Timbersaw pick. The Burning clinks. Everything just clicked for Vici Gaming here. They were ready for the Meepo LD. They were ready.
You know, the analysts talked a lot in the winner's bracket finals, and then here again about the versatility of